Hey everyone, Bright Fury back with another game. I know a while back I did a playthrough of the quarry, but that was before I had my sound equipment, so I'm going to be going through it again, this time with commentary. So buckle up and let's head to Hackett's Quarry. You guys should go check out his gaming channel. He is hilarious. Lin Shay is the queen. I'm just gonna comment every name that I see. Hey, Justin Smith. Cool guy. Brenda Zong! The queen of all our childhoods, especially those of us who were early 2000s kids.
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
I don't think Laura is an Ari fan.
Begins with an L? Like the L word?
Lesbians?
Lost, Max. We're lost.
We're in geographic flux.
Right, so lost.
That's debatable. Oh, heads up.
Got it.
Yeah, honey, nice catch.
Thank you. Man, the roads are definitely getting worse out here.
I guess it's all part of the rustic summer camp experience.
Oh, right, that's where we're going. I lost track like 200 miles ago.
200 miles ago, huh?
Yeah. You know what, Max? It's okay. It doesn't make you any less of a man.
You know, if Columbus hadn't gotten lost and landed on these golden shores, there would be no United States of America. Goodbye, hot dogs. See you later, apple pie.
Columbus never actually landed in North America.
What are you talking about?
Didn't even know he wasn't in Asia.
Are you serious?
Just another guy who didn't want to admit he was lost.
Well, just another guy who's got a whole day named after him, so put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Oh my god. Okay, just get us to camp already before I roll my eyes out of my head, please.
I'm working on it. What is that?
Yeah.
No, but seriously, how'll it happen to the normal map?
This is the normal map.
The one on the phone.
No bars.
Of course not.
Okay, let's see. So we are... Well, I guess they don't put summer camps on maps. Have you seen any signs for it? Hey, eyes on the road!
Stop
the car! Yes.
Okay, the ghost appearing in the car was really freaky.
Are you okay?
Yeah. I mean, still in one piece.
Jesus Christ, what do you think that was? A bear?
What? No,
Dude, it
no,
looked
Max, it
like a
wasn't a
bear.
bear.
What was it?
I think it was a person.
Laura, are you serious? Do you think we hit a person?
I don't know. I mean, it was really close, like really close, but maybe we didn't. What is it?
I really effed this car up.
Well, maybe it looks worse than it is.
I should check out the damage before we try to start it up again, huh? Could you grab my the toolbox from the trunk?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, let's be nosy. Oh, that sucks.
Max, why didn't you tell me?
Thanks, hon.
Yeah. Do you need a hand?
Yeah, actually, if you could just shine a light right here.
There you go.
Perfect, thank you.
The sooner we get out of here, the better.
Just picture yourself curling up in front of a big old fire pit singing campfire sing-alongs.
I don't think people curl up right in front of big old fire pits.
Why not?
They don't want to catch on fire. Then
I think we get the idea.
Anywhere is better than here.
Where are you going?
Just over here.
Just stay there for a second, okay? I'm almost done.
What do we do?
God, Max, hurry up!
What's going on?
I'm worried that there's somebody down there.
Are you serious?
Yeah, they could be hurt. I don't know.
I didn't think we actually hit anything.
Well, I don't know. I heard something, okay? Like a woman.
Do you think we hit her?
I just want to check it out.
Okay. All right. Just don't go too far, okay?
Be careful.
Yeah.
Oh, what a gentleman.
Okay. Luck with the car.
All right, let's explore. All right, I thought there was a way around there, but there's a dead end. Yay, we found our first tarot card. All right, the Fool. I wonder who this is. We all know a fool when we see one, don't we? Innocence and freedom? Or recklessness and risk-taking? Spontaneity? Actions without thought? But the consequences to match. Think, and don't get burnt. That's very cryptic. Harum Scarum Sideshow Spectacular. This is a poster for a traveling sideshow. It looks like it's been here a while, left forgotten in the woods. Are those burn marks around the edges? Okay, I think the best thing to do is to keep moving forward. What's in the box? Escapology trunk. A trunk filled with strange devices. That of an escapologist, perhaps. A relic of a traveling show that must have been... that must have passed through this area. Laura, come on. It's hard because sometimes you get so turned around when looking at something and then having to go a different direction.
Silence.
Ooh, that actually scared me. No. Get ready. Get ready, guys. Here we go. The scary voice. Everybody knows that.
Silence.
That actually sent chills down my spine.
What's going on? There's something out there. Like, there was noises all around me.
The last time I played this, okay. I got her.
There's a lot of stuff out there. There's animals. It's easy to freak yourself
from
out.
From the upper branch, and then
can we just
got
please?
Her.
Yeah. Let's go.
So this is turning out a lot better.
You all right?
Yes. There we go.
Burn like a kid.
Max, come on.
Here we go. We're getting out of here.
Me. Max!
I just... Okay, give me a minute.
We've got to go, Max!
All right, you're not helping right now.
Can you just... I am trying to get us out of here!
All right, enough!
Shit, I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
We're okay. We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Jesus!
Oh, fuck! Oh my god, my heart just exploded.
Roll it down.
Hi, officer. How are you doing this evening?
Are either of you injured?
Really, we're fine. We're just a little shaken up.
Well, you folks want to tell me what happened here?
Yeah.
Okay, to make things safe, we're gonna be honest.
Something jumped out right in front of the car and we didn't want to hit it, so we swerved and now here we are.
Something jumped out?
Again, we're gonna keep up the honesty.
I'm sorry, it was so dark and it happened so fast and they were gone.
They? Ma'am, did you hit someone?
No, God, no, of course not. You know, I mean, I don't think so. I don't know.
Sir?
Oh?
Keep the car running.
The cop seems anxious.
Is this kind of like the all-time scariest cop?
I don't know. This is my first cop.
What, like ever?
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
Now, you folks want to tell me just what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night?
We're heading up to Hackett's Quarry summer camp.
The best thing to do is be non-confrontational.
You're one
night
early.
That's just my opinion.
No, we know.
I know this is a game.
But we figured we'd get in early and scope it out, you know? I mean, they know we're coming. We called ahead.
And to be honest, sir, one of us kind of oversold their navigation skills and got us completely lost.
You're not going to make it to Hackett's Quarry. Not tonight. Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest
place.
You can bunk up there for the night, okay?
I think we're just gonna stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming and we called ahead.
No, ma'am, you're gonna head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
Let's be compliant.
Okay, fine. Yeah, we'll head to the motel. Understood. There's just one small problem.
I forgot to spring for the middle of nowhere coverage plan on my phone.
What he means is we're lost. Completely.
All right, ma'am. Step out of the vehicle.
Wait, what?
I just want to show you how to get to the motel on your map there. Okay?
For sure.
Son, remain in the vehicle.
It's okay.
Okay.
Okay. So, we... are right about here. Harbinger Motel is here.
Right, okay, and where was Hackett's Quarry again?
Well, I'm sure the fine folks at the Harbinger Motel can guide you there first thing in the morning. Harbinger Motel. Stay on the road.
Wait, but what if there's someone out there?
Yeah, I'll have a look. Good night.
Why is this guy just sitting there?
That guy was giving me major weirdo
vibes. The dude needed like at least a dozen showers.
Oh my god, I know.
What was up with the thing? Did you see that?
Was it blood?
Nice to meet you.
Get back on the road.
Yes.
I think I've had enough woodland encounters for one night. Thank you very much.
Agreed. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here.
Mm-hmm.
And the motel is here.
Okay.
But we're going here.
What's there?
Hackett's quarry.
How'd you do that?
I don't know. I kind of tricked him into showing me.
Very slick. Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel and just listen to this guy's advice?
Honey, you really want to listen to the advice of some creep-ass cop who told us in the middle of the creep-ass woods to go to some creep-ass hotel?
No, that sounds terrible.
Yeah.
Let's hit the road, shall we?
That's what I thought.
Ma'am?
Oh my god! If he called me ma'am one more time, I was gonna shove that badge up his dick hole. Seriously, do I look like a ma'am to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
What?
20's... debatable.
Easy.
I mean, I'm kind of into ma'ams.
Okay, we're done here.
You gotta be kidding me. There's nobody here. We drive all the way the fuck out
Max,
here.
Max, can we just look around before we jump to conclusions?
Did you actually even talk to Mr. Hackett, or did you just leave a message?
Well, what's the difference?
This is the difference.
Hello?
I guess he doesn't check his voicemail.
How was I supposed to know that? I mean, clearly there's somebody here.
Yeah, or it's just an abandoned car, and this is a complete waste
of
time.
Why would there be an abandoned...
I'll beat the car.
Max, come on. Max, don't be a dick.
I'm sorry.
Is anybody home?
Best to check again for good measure. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Fun.
That is a weird motto to
what
have.
What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Thank you.
be right back. I'm gonna get some help. Max! Max, get over here!
What's going on?
There's somebody in the bunker. I think they might be stuck.
Stuck? Is it Mr. Hackett?
I don't know. Just bring some tools so we can break the lock. Hey, I'm back. We're gonna get you out of there.
Hey.
Wait, what are these?
I don't know. You just said tools.
Why didn't you just bring... Look, there's someone in there.
I'm not seeing anyone.
What? No, look.
I'm looking. I am.
There was definitely someone there.
Okay, so...
I think the wrenches are the best bet.
You sure?
Yeah, saw it online.
Oh, yeah.
You need a hand?
Yeah.
You've seen the Evil Dead, right?
Hello? Are you hurt?
Do you exist?
Do you exist? Max is underrated.
Hey, be careful.
This bloodied collar looks too big for a dog. What kind of dog would be called Ian anyway? Oh, that is disgusting.
Max?
Maybe it was a possum or something.
No, there was someone here, I swear.
Hey, it's been kind of a night, you know? Let's just get to the motel. We can come back here first thing in the morning. We can check everything out, but...
Yep,
I mean,
that's
you must
probably
be exhausted.
Wise.
I know I am. I think our imagination...
Max!
Oh, that's chilling.
I think I'm bleeding a lot.
Yeah, let's be a good girlfriend. Path chosen.
Thank you.
like the goddamn Harbinger Motel to you?
You know, you guys, I think he really wants them to go to the Harbinger Motel. I don't know.
Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me know what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore.
The core.
You are. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
Hello, my friend. Welcome
hey,
to the show.
Hey, Eliza Voorhees.
We are friends, aren't we?
Are we?
I've waited for you. I've waited. Yes. So I do hope our time together proves enlightening. There's no need to worry. I'm here to help you. Think of me as your guide into the unknown. It's exciting. Yes. And terrifying. But if you're brave enough, if you let me help you, I can help you. We can help each other.
Okay.
This is the card you found.
Yep.
The Fool. I wonder who this is. We all know a fool when we see one, don't we? Innocence and freedom. Or recklessness and risk-taking. Spontaneity. Actions without thought, but the consequences to match. Think. Think, and don't get burnt. I can show you more if you'd like me to.
Yeah, let's see more.
This is what might come to pass. A possible future. A path yet unchosen. Look here, look here.
Alright, let's see what we got. Oh.
There are secrets out there, you know. Secrets and lies. Paths to uncover on which I can shed light, if you let me. Help me help you.
Help me help you.
And remember, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Alright, we finished the prologue. Now the fun really gets to start. Chapter 1, Hackett's Quarry, Forever.
Love.
See you later, kids.
Yeah, Hackett's Quarry forever.
You know how many hearts are broken on the last day of summer camp? It's like a romance apocalypse.
Hmm. And you never know. The universe has a kind of way of working these things out.
The universe?
Okay,
yeah,
I
like
love
the cosmic.
He needs more love.
Space gods.
Space gods.
You heard me?
Okay, spell it.
Nothing to spell. You know, we're cool.
Oh, so cool.
We are super cool.
So she dumped her ass, huh?
Okay, quit it.
Hi, Emma.
Hey.
Okay, this is, you've heard of spatial awareness before, right?
Spatial awareness is for nerds. Be a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will you?
Yes, boss.
Be a lamb.
Say hi to Emma for me.
You're a bad person.
Yes, I am.
Okay. Ooh, let's go say hi to Ryan real quick.
Hey, what are you listening to? Before they knew it, the good to know.
All right, let's go get those bags.
Hey, are you guys gonna help with the bags or what?
Oh, you know, I was actually just working on fixing the door. It's
Dylan, come
it's
on.
Broken.
Dylan, please.
I can't. It's,
Dylan, I gotta get the last bag.
Sure,
come on.
This thing is
Dylan, please.
Sorry, bro.
Cool. Yes. Thanks, guys.
It's the other way. All right. Hackett's Quarry Summer Camp was established way back in 1953, and it's still going on strong today, nearly 70 years on. Insert Mission Impossible theme song.
Oh, skill. Ugh. Horror. I hate horror. All right, got the bags.
Great, all by yourself, huh?
Yep.
Guess you're gonna have to get used to that.
Oh my god, you are so mean.
At least I'm honest.
Oh, okay, here we go.
It's so cool.
You're not telling me the whole truth about you and Emma.
The evolution of Brenda's song since The Sweet Life of Zack and Cody. Okay, let's be playful. Turn it back on her.
Oh, okay. So now I'm the one who's not telling the whole story, huh?
Oh, well, this is the bait I just gotta take, Jake.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. I just got so distracted about that rhyme. I forgot what we
were... Oh, no. You were telling me how you totally have a thing for Ryan.
Wait, are we talking about Ryan, the sailing instructor with the sexy brooding loner thing that totally doesn't do anything for me at all?
Knew it.
Who said I was hiding that?
I'm not. I'm just saying, you know, I feel like if you really did like the guy, you would have made a move by now.
So she really just dumped her ass, huh?
I don't... Okay. Her whole thing is like, how are we going to make this work? Different schools, blah, blah, blah. My whole thing is like, you know, maybe long distance, blah, 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 blah. And she was just like, Jacob.
She gave you the look, huh?
Yeah, do not pass go.
Man, she has got you wrapped all the way around that dainty little finger of hers. How does she do it?
Okay, let's give him a boost of confidence.
No, but I mean, seriously, come on, she's right. It's just like a stupid summer fling. What else did I think was going to happen?
Let's see. Love, stability, engagement, marriage, house, kid, affair, kid, divorce, loneliness, child support, visitation lawsuit, surprise reconciliation, emptiness, retirement, grandkid, nursing home, and finally, dying in each other's arms and then being buried in each other's arms like those 1,000-year-old skeletons they dug up in Rome or something. That kind
oh
of
my
ballpark?
Goodness.
Oh, shit, I'm sorry. That was Ryan and me. Let me see. Ah, here it is. Yours just says Roadhead. Oh, actually, that's just a generic all-men list.
Well, that seems legit. Okay, so are we sure that
Caitlin
this old dust bucket's roadworthy?
We'll take a look. It better be. One more night in the great outdoors might actually kill me.
Hey, it doesn't kill you. Will make you stronger.
Well, I haven't killed you yet. You're still pretty pathetic.
Hey, shut up. Okay, so total hypothetical, but if I was like a huge asshole and I wanted to break down the van so we'd have to spend another night here, what exactly would I need to do?
Well, you'd probably break the fuel line or, I don't know, rip out the rotor arm. And yes, that would make you a total asshole.
Okay, and what does a rotor arm look like again?
It's like an arm that's all rotary. You know, it's under the little black dome with the leads poking out.
Don't Jake, give him the
you
information.
Realize that even if we somehow did get stuck out here, one more night with Emma wouldn't make a difference. Trust me, chick's made up her mind.
Yeah. Sure. Guess we'll just have to find out.
Okay, let's not cause any dangers.
Come on with me, buddy. I'll put you right back tomorrow. No harm, no foul.
Up here, my dudes.
Why do they look like they're up to something?
Hey, Jacob.
What? No, dude, please. Don't.
Go long.
Oh,
we got it.
Boom. Oh, there it is.
Oh, man, good sight.
Freak.
Oh.
Oh, I wish I had some sense.
Surrounded by freaks. Oh, thank God.
Surrounded by freaks.
I'm gonna get the whole no technology thing, but take me back, world.
You would have thought Mr. H could have, like, charged up our phones, like, a little bit.
Nothing's ever your fault, is it?
You know, you should really just save it for emergencies only. Unless, of course, is being dumped an emergency?
Oh, Ben.
Okay, well, at least I had a relationship this summer.
Ooh, damn, now we burn.
Yeah, well, maybe not everyone is looking for a hookup.
Okay, let's all put our little dicks away and get this show on the road, huh?
Where's everybody else?
Why would I know that?
Mm-hmm. Sometimes you know stuff I don't.
Look, I don't even know how to respond to that.
You say, Nick, you're way smarter than me, and you're a super hot stud who gets any cheeky ones.
Okay, yeah, keep dreaming, Junior.
I love Abby. She's so adorable.
Hey there, Party Bear.
Status report?
We are officially empty nesters. High five up top.
Oh boy.
Imagine
you're
if
about
I
to get your phone back, aren't you?
Let's go collect our bags and away from this mosquito-infested backwoods dump.
Doors locked, bags inside.
Fuck me.
Yep.
Well, it's obvious what we have to do here.
Find someone with a key?
Shape our destiny. Then by shape our destiny, I mean shape our way through this crappy lock and grab our bags.
Okay, let's do it. We better not get into trouble.
I won't tell if you won't tell.
Mr. Hackett's gonna find out.
So what? I'll just think it was a bear or something.
Have you ever seen a bear in these woods?
No, but that doesn't mean they're not out there.
Fair point.
All right, let's do this. On three. One. Two. Three! Ugh. All about the power of positive thinking.
Why do I ever listen to you?
Because I'm always right.
Are you sure they're gonna think it was a bear?
Oh, my God, relax. It's not like we killed someone.
All right, well, I'm just gonna take another look around, make sure we didn't miss anything.
Go nuts!
All right, let's get hunting.
Ouch. Let's hope Jacob hasn't seen this.
An empty vial with an unpleasant odor.
Ew, what is that? Is it Dylan's?
I have a feeling there might be a tarot card around here somewhere. Oh wait, we already looked at that. Wasn't it letting me interact? There we go. Though it is a novelty, though this is a novelty signpost, it also acts as a chilling reminder that Hackett's Quarry really is a long way from anywhere. Just want to scope out the area.
It's not gonna be happy that the kids just left this year. I told Chris about it.
A recording of the Hackett's Quarry camp song from years gone by. Technology may have moved on, but the song remains unchanged.
Right when we see him.
Alright, let's go find Emma. Oh, there she is. Oops. Thought we could go through there. I promise I know what I'm doing.
Ready to roll?
I love her thinking face.
Let's do it. Fine.
Time to let loose and vamoose this caboose.
How are you so
dramatic?
Annoying. Confident.
Annoyingly confident.
It's what the people want.
So you're faking it?
I mean, in a way, faking it is just being yourself. But louder. You should try it sometime. You never know who you might impress.
No. It's too late now anyway.
For what? You and Nick? You never know unless you put yourself out there.
Oh, wow! Oh.
Nice steering, Tex.
Jinkies. Okay,
love
so hypothetically,
reference.
If I were to put myself out there, what if he ends up being a dud, kind of like you and Jacob?
He's actually really sweet.
Then why'd you quit it?
Summer fling. We're going to school like four states away. He gets it.
Yeah, sure.
Does he though?
But that's us. You and Nick could be different. When do you get his handle? Hit him up.
Oh, I already have his email. It was in the packet they gave to us on the first day.
Email? Are you 93?
What's wrong with email?
I'm really gonna miss you, Abby.
Oh, hold up!
Oh, but the lodge is that way.
Go right here.
Why?
Come on, scenic route? One last victory lap around the camp?
Let's live a little.
Sure. What's the victory?
2 months.
No technology.
I kind of thought it was nice to be offline.
Ugh, I didn't. Plus, my subs need me.
You know what? I actually believe you.
Abby, was that a compliment?
Your charm is infectious. What can I say? I'd subscribe.
You better. As soon as you get home, sub, share, smash that like button.
Which is what you guys should
do. Well, now I'm really regretting it.
Oh no, you love me. My favorite spot?
The fire pit?
The island. Mad secluded, right? Is that smoke?
Should we tell someone?
It looks pretty contained. It's probably just Mr. H burning some stuff before, you know, he closes camp for the summer.
Yeah. Speaking of which, we should probably, you know, get back.
Oh, yeah. Worried Nick's, you know, gonna leave without you?
Well, no. They're probably, like, all waiting for us.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's waiting for us.
Everyone, yeah. Nick, waiting for you. All, everyone, same.
Don't worry, Jacob. I got you. I got a full tank of gas, so... Oh, fuck me.
Oh, idiot.
Is nobody on phone chargers anymore?
There's no signal out here anyways, dude, okay? This place is, like, patchy as balls.
Your balls are patchy?
Oh, what? My
no.
Gosh. So childish.
It's okay. I'll just go get some juice from Mr. H before we go.
Ew.
Hey, Nick.
Hey, where were you guys?
Wouldn't you like to know? Ignore her, please.
Let's go. Just gotta get these bags up onto the...
Oh, hey, here. Let me get it for you.
I can take care of my own bag, thank you.
Are you sure? Because, I mean, it's really not that big of a deal.
She can take care of her own bag, thank you.
We can both take care of our own bag, thank you.
Cool.
Let's be a good wingman.
Abby, do you need...
I love how everybody knows that Nick and Abby like each other, but neither one of them want to make the first move.
Hey, has anyone seen Ryan?
Oh yeah, he's probably off being all brooding and mysterious and alluring somewhere.
I'm here.
What were you doing under there? Having a little me party?
I was listening to a podcast, actually.
Oh, podcast. Nice, that's cool.
What's it about?
Let's shake it up.
I think it's
bit.
Called How to Mind Your Own Business. You should listen to it.
Ghosts.
Ghosts?
Yeah, well, all sorts of cryptozoology, really. The episode I was listening to is actually about this place.
Oh, yeah, yeah, the one that you were talking about to the kids at the campfire.
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Yes.
Not the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
What's the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
You don't know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
If I did, would I be asking, dumbass?
Tell her about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I don't think she wants to know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Can we just please stop saying the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
It's just this campfire story for the kids. It's, there's supposedly an old woman who died in a fire a few years back. She haunts the woods looking for her lost baby boy. There are, like, reports of whispers or whatever, and this figure that floats around, you know, textbook ghost stuff. Some people say that if she catches you alone, she'll try to turn you into her son. Or kill you. Or something. I don't know. It's never really been clear. Anyways, Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
You made that up.
It's right here in the podcast, man.
Cool story, bro.
Let's be annoying.
Oh, yeah? You got a cooler one?
Oh, no. I wasn't being sarcastic.
I didn't really tell it right.
Look, no. Seriously, dude. I think it came out wrong.
You gotta be careful with this stuff, man. This shit's true.
Come on, dude. Bullshit.
What's the holdup, Hacketeers?
Nearly done, Mr. H.
We're up to it. Get those butts in gear.
Sorry, Mr. H.
You had to liberate some luggage.
Shut up.
Maybe if somebody didn't spend so much time trying to press the ladies' ball as ghost stories.
You asked.
Ghost stories?
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Oh! Hey, you still have the van key, Mr. H?
Well, yes, I do. You know, I'd lose my head if it wasn't stuck on. Back to the office I go. Give me a hand, would you, Ryan?
Oh, okay.
Yo, Mr. H.
What's up, DJ Dylan?
Any chance I could get a little charge? I want to have some tunes for the road.
No can do.
Okay, let's be understanding. We were already super annoying before.
Cool, yeah. No worries.
Good man.
No big deal. You can share my earbuds.
That's so nice, Ryan.
So, Chris, I'm actually glad we got a moment to talk.
I'm not fired, am I?
No, it's just, you know, about the whole thing with the...
Hold that thought, partner. I'm gonna have to take this.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sorry.
Hello.
Do we want to listen to the podcast or do we want to eavesdrop? Let's do it different this time.
Sorry about that, bud. Sorry about that, bud. Didn't mean to push you out like that.
That was funny.
You need a hand looking for the keys?
No, end of summer, busy, you know. Anyway, you were asking me?
Oh, yeah, it was just the whole animation school thing, what you thought I should do.
Right.
Whether or not I should, like, leave my sister with my grandparents, since I'd have to live on campus, you know, and my mom's not exactly around, so I wouldn't want to leave Sarah on her own. You know, our family's small enough as it is.
Well, family is important, Ryan.
Dang it.
Is everything okay? You got a hot day tonight?
Oh boy.
If you only knew.
So, what did you need me for?
You're one of my favorite counselors, Ryan. You know that. One of the good ones. But do you know how many calls I get from parents, letter after letter, with these terrified kids that they send home?
Huh. I didn't realize that.
Believe it or not, scaring kids away from sleepaway camp is kind of bad for business. So maybe just ease up on the ghost stories.
Sorry, I didn't realize it was such a big deal.
Gotta understand the repercussions of your actions, Buster. It's a big part of being a counselor, a leader.
Yeah.
Just stick to kumbaya next time, okay?
What's that?
You guys don't do kumbaya anymore?
Nobody does kumbaya anymore.
I'm outgrowing my own cliches.
Seriously, Chris, what's going on?
I just want to get you guys safely out of Dodge before the sun goes down.
Why?
It's getting dark, Ryan, and it's not safe to drive in the dark. And safety is the first step towards fun. Just give me a minute. Where in the good goddamn are they?
Will you say goodbye to Caleb and Kaylee for me? They sort of just snuck off.
Well, you'll see him again next year. Caleb works at the scrapyard during the off-season, and Kaylee, well, she's still figuring out what she wants to do. She's got her whole life ahead of her. They both just come and go as they please, really. Teenagers, am I right?
Actually, could have used the help packing up since we were short-staffed.
Hey, you guys seem to manage all right. But I'll tell them both you were sad you missed them. Unlocked the van, put the keys in my pocket, came in the office. Right where I left him. Let's skedaddle. Make sure they're all ready to go. For real this time.
Wait, how did you get your phone back before the rest of us?
I never turned it in.
Smart.
You should have turned it off before you handed it in, Dylan. Them's the rules, you noob.
I try not to dwell on the past, man.
Good. Because it's time to dwell in the minivan. Get on with our respective lives. Move it, let's go. What's the problem?
Ugh, dude, I don't know. I think there's something wrong with the engine, Mr. H.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, dude, it's just like kaput.
All right, let me try.
He's a little too casual.
All right, it's busted.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
What the fuck, dude?
Enough. Enough, both of you. Shit. Come on.
All right,
come
on. Chill. Chill, dude. God. Damn it.
I thought I told you kids to check everything.
We did. It should be working.
Yeah, well, coulda and shoulda doesn't mean it is, does it? Okay.
Look, it's not that big of a deal, okay? We'll just spend one more night here.
No! No! Just stop. Let me think. Okay. Damn it. You're right, yeah.
What?
Yeah, you're right.
Yes.
Hey, Brian. Come here for a sec. Make sure that everybody is inside the lodge for tonight. Lock the doors. No one in, no one out. No one. Got it?
Okay.
I'll be back first thing in the morning. And we'll get you all on the road. You just have to keep everyone inside. Can you promise me you'll do that?
Yeah, sure. We'll stay inside.
Attaboy. Lock the doors! And for God's sake, keep the noise down!
So, what was that about?
Said to stay inside, that we're not leaving until the morning.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? What are we supposed to do?
Well, we should go inside, like he said.
We could go inside until morning.
Yeah.
Or...
which is the smart thing to do.
Or we could do something else.
No. We should really listen to what Chris told us to do.
Of course.
Who cares what Chris told us to do? He's not our boss anymore. P-A-R-T. Why the fuck not? All right, it seems like the stars have aligned for us, no?
Okay.
One last epic bonfire blowout for all time.
Oh, dude. Fuck yes. I'm in. Nick, you're in.
Yeah, I'm in.
Dylan's in, obviously. My man. Caitlin?
I go where my people need me.
Yeah, okay. Em, what do you say?
Yeah, I'm in. Mr. Hackett seemed pretty insistent we stay in the lodge.
He was just trying to freak us out, you know? Like one of Ryan's stupid ghost stories.
Why would he want to scare us?
I don't think he was trying to freak us out, Jacob. I think he was really freaked out by something.
Jesus Christ.
Chris seemed real serious about this, guys.
Just say you're in, man. Come on, one last night.
Yeah,
dude, he won't even know.
I promised.
No, dude. It's all good, all right? We get it. You know, you don't want to disappoint Daddy.
Whatever, man.
It's gonna be fine, man. Trust me. It's gonna be chill.
All right. Hacketeers! Party planning committee, let's do this. Okay, first things first. Nick and Abby, you go get some firewood. Em and I will go to the stores for some supplies. And, Dylan, you just, I don't know, figure out how to charge the phones or something. All right, let's do this!
All right, this is where we're going to stop the video for today. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one. This is Bright Fury, signing out.